I personally love idlis so much that I can have them at any time of the day. If you love them as much as I do, I'm sure you will be hooked to today's recipe, instant rava idli. Firstly, in a heated kadhai, I am taking 1 tablespoon of oil. Once the oil heats, add 4 to 5 cashew nuts, split. We will fry them until they turn slightly golden. Let's take them out. Next, add 1/2 a teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of chana dal, 1 green chili chopped, 1 teaspoon of ginger grated, 7 to 8 curry leaves chopped. Let's saute this for a minute. To this, I'm adding 1 cup of rava. Let's roast the rava. We are roasting the rava so that the idlis do not turn out to be sticky after steaming. A well-roasted rava will take time to fall down from the spatula, otherwise it will fall down smoothly. Rava is roasted. Let's take this out and we will let this cool down. The rava has cooled down. To this, I'm adding 1/2 a cup of whisked curd, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of chopped coriander leaves. Mix it well. Now, I'm adding around 1/4 cup of water. Mix. We will cover this and leave it to rest for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of fruit salt, around 3 tablespoons of water. Gently mix. The rava idli batter is ready. Now, to prepare the idli plate for steaming the idlis, I'm greasing them with oil. Next, place the fried split cashews in the center of the idli mold. Now, transfer the batter to the plates. In the steaming kadhai, I have water heating. The plates need to be carefully inserted inside the steamer. Close the lid. We will steam the idlis for 15 minutes on medium flame. The idlis are done. Let's take them out. Serve them hot with fresh coconut chutney and enjoy. Until we meet again, eat well, live well, and stay blessed.